Michael Stewart and Scott McDonald are with me on this week's SPFL review. Still five Premiership games to come, and let's push on with the action. Hearts against Aberdeen was maybe the pick of the whole weekend, and Michael Stewart watched on for us.
The Hearts support have turned up in their numbers today. Despite the uncertain future surrounding the club off the pitch, it's approaching a sellout at Tynecastle. Aberdeen have brought with them a big travelling support here to the capital, and they'll be looking to continue their good form in the league. The team will be trying to turn around their poor recent record here at Tynecastle, where they haven't won since January 2010, and also haven't scored here in over 6 hours.
What's a break from Hearts, it's a goal! And he has given the penalty. He strikes it and he puts it away into the back of the net. Oh, it's a goal! Hearts!
Well, it was certainly a lively encounter here at Tynecastle, with Aberdeen having most of the opportunities in the first half. In particular, Scott Vernon having clear-cut opportunities one-on-one with the goalkeeper that he'll surely be disappointed that he didn't take advantage of. Even though it was Aberdeen who had the best opportunities in the first half, it was Hearts who took the lead through a fantastic solo goal from Jamie Walker for the second week in a row. It all started with a good bit of passing play in the right back area, and Jamie Walker was released and took on his defender and put the ball in the bottom corner to put his team 1-0 up. Walker's goal really lifted the home support, and they managed to hold on to the lead going into half-time, leaving Gary Locke the happier of the two managers. Not long into the second half, Scott Vernon, who had a number of opportunities in the first half, was replaced by Calvin Zola, who ultimately wasn't able to change the luck in front of goal for Aberdeen. However, it was the big striker who managed to get Aberdeen back into the game, drawing a challenge from Kevin McCarthy inside the box, which the referee deemed worthy of a penalty kick and a sending off. Although replays have shown that the young Hearts fullback got plenty of the ball, and he'll no doubt feel very much hard done by with the sending off. Niall McGinn made no mistake as he stepped up to slot the ball home from the penalty spot, levelling the game 1-1 and swinging the momentum in Aberdeen's favour. Not long after, Aberdeen had another claim for a penalty, although this time the referee gave a yellow card for diving. Although down to 10 men, the young Hearts team managed to play some nice football, keeping the ball and creating a few half chances. Aberdeen had a fantastic opportunity to go ahead late in the game through Niall McGinn. Unfortunately, he was unable to direct his header on goal, and a minute later Hearts were up the other end with a free kick, and young Jordan McGee rose above everyone else to power home a header and send the Tynecastle faithful wild. Aberdeen piled on the pressure late in the game, but they were unable to breach the Hearts defence. It was a hard-earned 3 points for the Tynecastle men, and the home support well and truly played their part. They now find themselves on minus 8 points as the fight for survival this season goes on.
Delighted with 3 points because obviously when Kevin gets sent off, you're down to 10 men, you think, you know, you settle for a point. But, you know, a great header for Jordan at the back post, and we're all delighted with 3 points.
Certainly we knew that Hearts, with the crowd that got behind them and the passion they've shown recently, they wouldn't need too many excuses to get behind their team. And we've gave them, for me, a gift of a goal when we've had three or four, you know, clear-cut opportunities ourselves. You know, we should have been out of sight in even the first 15, 20 minutes. So, you know, our lack of conviction and our failure to get ourselves in front come back to cost us. And I think that the goal we lose certainly galvanises this, you know, real passionate Hearts crowd.
We're up against it, we're 15 points adrift. And certainly there's been one or two decisions so far this season I felt went against us. Again, you know, I thought it was a soft decision, I'd need to see it again, but then I lose a player, which is, you know, more worrying for me because I've lost Ryan Stevenson, I'm now losing Kevin McCarthy, and we certainly can't afford to lose too many.
More wonderful support from the Hearts fans, 15,000 plus inside Tynecastle. Great atmosphere, but did Aberdeen maybe deserve better?
I think, you know, over the piece that it was a disappointing afternoon for Aberdeen. If they'd taken their chances, they could well have, you know, walked away from Tynecastle with 3 points. They've got a poor record there in recent history, and that was a good opportunity on Saturday to rectify that.
And my word, they had some chances, Scott Vernon too. But Kevin McCarthy is the first real big talking point. Sent off for this challenge in the box as well, just to rub it in. How did you see this?
Yeah, for me, I'm sorry, referees, but it wasn't a penalty for me. He's done excellent to get round him. He's not come from behind, he's come from round him. And, you know, I think Aberdeen are lucky there.
This is football. You know, we need to remember that there's going to be contact. It's not basketball. It's a physical sport. and he's got plenty of the ball there. And as Scott says, he's come from the side, it's not from behind. And, you know, Calvin Zola's a fair unit. That shouldn't be enough to warrant a penalty.
Yeah, and that's three penalties already this season for Niall McGinn. He took that one really well. Now, Peter Pollitt next is the next talking point here. He goes through and he's booked maybe his reputation before him here. Should this have been a penalty?
I think, you know, looking at that, when you see the second angle here with the closer angle, the defender does get a slight touch on the ball. But for me, this is where there's enough contact on the player that warrants a penalty. Yeah. And it possibly is the case that Pollitt's had the reputation last year. He's been cited for diving before. And maybe that comes into play in the referee's thinking.
Maybe a wee deviation in the ball there, but not enough to maybe not
maybe, maybe
say
it's not a enough for a penalty. But, you know, it's harsh that he's been booked. I think when you play in the Scottish top flight, there's only so many referees. And once you get that reputation, it sticks. And we can clearly see on this occasion that's been the case.
Now, Derek McInnes and Billy Brown into his 60s now as well, got in a bit of a dust-up after this game. It looks as if they're both going to be banned from the touchline. Michael, you saw this as well. What happened?
Well, yeah, we saw it and nobody was really sure what had gone on. It was a real fracas at the side of the pitch, and I think Derek McInnes has come out and said that, you know, he's held his hands up, he was wrong. But, you know, Billy Brown, he's pushing 60 and he was... I think he might be in his 60s.
He is in his 60s.
Yeah, he was...
Well, thank you for that.
I think what had happened is he jumped from his side of the dugout over at the Aberdeen dugout, and Dale took exception to that and gave him a shove.
Yeah, he wouldn't do that again. Oh. Danny Wilson as well, we should say, the Hearts captain, was sent off after the game for some foul and abusive language in the tunnel. Maybe the less said about what he said, the better, if the newspaper reports are correct. But when you look at that Hearts team, the starting 11 at the weekend, 9 of them came through the academy at Riccarton. I know you know the club very well, but that's astounding, isn't it, Michael?
Yeah, it is. You know, it's... I think it's more of an indication of where the club are financially rather than saying that the academy has done fantastically well to bring through a lot of those players. Saying that, you know, there's quite a few guys in there that are real talents, and I think when you look at that caption, that, you know, the big thing that jumps out is, apart from Dylan McGowan, everyone else is Scottish. And hopefully, you know, that's a picture that's right across the board in the Scottish Premiership, and I think that will bode well for the national team in the future.
That's something you've not quite seen for many a year at Hearts.
It's amazing,
either,
isn't it?
You know, so many Scottish flags on there.
And some high hopes, including Jamie Walker, who have scored another big goal this weekend, a big one as well at Partick Thistle. You like what you see here, don't you, Scott?
Yeah, it's been a fantastic start. You know, he's really enthusiastic and he's very confident. And you can see when he picks the ball up, he just wants to drive at players, like we've seen, you know, against Partick Thistle. We'll see it in a minute. You know, the goal that he scored here, it is here. You know, just driving at players, you know, he's full of confidence, and you know, what a fantastic finish that is.
And you like him a lot, Michael?
Yeah, I mean, technically, he's possibly the top one out of the youngsters at Tynecastle, and he's got a lot to learn in terms of the game, but he'll get the opportunity to do that now.
Okay.